Okay. So good morning, everyone. In this session, we are going to solve a sectional orthographic projection of this particular given object. And then before solving the question, that it is must to calculate the maximum length, width, and height. So if you consider this one, this arrow indicates that the front view direction, and this side would be the side view direction. And the cutting plane is here from A to A. So that's why you will get the sectional front view here. Getting? You will get the sectional front view here in this particular diagram. So here, while calculating maximum length, the 12 plus 65 plus 30. So it's around 107, 12 plus 65 plus this radius. So it is around 107. Then maximum height, it is clearly defined here. Maximum height is 80 here. And maximum width, you can find maximum width here. That is, it is also 80. So 80, the maximum length 107, width 80, and length 107, width 80, height 80. So this is how it is that required to calculate all the dimensions. Now according to that, we have to decide the positions. So arrow is from this side. So here it is the right hand side view on the left side. Here you will get the side view, and here you will get the front view, and here you will get the top view. Now next part is that in the empty region, you have to draw a 45 degree line. So I'll start here to draw 45 degree line. At the right length of the line, let us take a 100. Less than angle 225, so automatically it will create the angle of 45 with the XY line. Getting? So if you want, you can extend it. So you can extend up to this one. That's it. Now I have just shifted this X axis somewhat above. Why? Because the 80 is there. So height 80, width 80. So 160, and total page size is a 210. So that 160 plus this 10, so 180 would be there, and around this 20, so it would be very close. So that's why I have just shifted this x-axis somewhat above, like 5 mm or 10 mm. Then it is not exactly at the middle, so I will start the preparing limits or block for this. So angle here it is 80, so 80 height. Then here it is 107, then this one and this one. So I'll check out whether it is 107 or not. 107, yeah, it's correct. Okay, now same way, this should have a 09 color. So I'll use here 09, and similar to that, you have to create, you have to draw top view also. So width is also 80 from the, for the top view, you require length and width. So length I will get from the front view, and then width is here. Okay, now the next part, that you can create the dimensions for the side view. So I will just take the projection here. So whenever it is very close, so we have to take care of this. Otherwise it will create like this. Or second option is you can directly connect to this. Okay, then this is already taken. So this is already taken. I have to take only this part. So it is automatically take width and height. So it would be a square, that 80 by 80. Then you can just trim the remaining part. Likewise, you have to prepare it. Then I will just leave this upper portion because where it is close to this background. Now next part, which view we have to draw first. So if you observe this, the more circles are clearly visible in the top view. So that's why I will start with the top view. One can start with the side view also. One can start with the front view also, no matter. But here it is a sectional front view. So I will keep later on that part. Sectional front view means if I cut along AA, then how that object would be visible? Because when you cut it, that holes are open. This rib is also going to be open. So how that sectional section lines you have to draw, that you have to think whenever you draw the front view. Okay. But no matter, I will start with the top view. So for while drawing the top view, you have to draw first center line. It is exactly at the middle of the width. And this vertical center line for this hole is from this, R is equal to 30, means from this side 30. So I will just create the center lines. Start with this one. This one is a middle center line. And then this side 30, 30, and then draw vertical line. Then just delete it and just make it as a center line. Okay. Now next part, you have to draw the circles. So this outer circle radius equal to 30. So you can change it to black color and just take this 30 mm. radius. Then one more circle is there inside that. There is a 40 diameter and 25 diameter. So radius equal to 20 first, then radius equal to 12.5. So these all circles I have drawn, but this outer circle is only half circle. So you can trim it. Getting? Now, if you consider this from the top, you will get the rectangle for this. And this is a throughout 80 mm rectangle. If you see from the top, this part, for this part, you will get a rectangle of thickness of how many mm? 12 mm. So 12 mm thickness is there. 12 mm thickness is there. And width is 80. So you can start with this one. This one, 12 mm. Okay. After that, if you observe, this is connected to this one, but here it is what mentioned that here it is around a curve and having radius equal to 15. So I'll just connect it first throughout, and then we will draw the curve afterwards. Okay. Then we will try with some, what we can say, that particular fillet. Otherwise, there is another option how to draw this one. So I will keep as it is right now. I will solve this at the end only. Now, after that, there is one rib. So this rib is having thickness around 10. Okay, so it's 10 mm. So 5 mm this side, 5 mm this side. So you can make an offset of this center line. So that would be better. And then you can make an offset of 5 mm this side, okay. Then you just draw a line with this to this. It's starting from this and ending with this. And afterwards you can delete that lines. So this line is required to delete, this is required to delete. Okay. Okay. So this rib is visible here. Now almost we have completed the top view. Some basic part is remaining. Okay. Now next part. This one. So we have to take the projection from the top to front. Okay. So quickly I will take the projection from the top to front. So you can take the 09 color over there quickly. And then I'll start with this one. So you can see here this part. Then for this circle also we have to take the projections. So here I will start with this one. So I will take full projections here. Then afterwards you can trim it or you can keep as it is. Okay. After that I will take a black color and then I'll start with this one. So if you observe this bottom portion is having rectangle. If you see from the front, so having thickness we have to check out. So here it is given 10 mm thickness is given here. So, okay. Now, what we have to do here that we are drawing here first this thickness of 10 mm. So here, okay, so here it is a 10 mm one step is there. So that rectangle we have to draw first. So I'll start with this 10 mm rectangle and it is up to this one. Okay, so I will just join this to this. So while drawing the sectional front view, you have to draw with some whatever the normal as like a normal orthographics, and then we will think about the section lines. Okay, so if you consider this one of the rectangle here, you can observe. So it is an L like shape you will get. If you want, you can trim it this one. Okay. Then next part is there that this cylinder, and this cylinder is starting from this surface to upper surface. So having this height is equal to 30 mm, right? So I will just draw the 30 mm height. 30. Then, so you just draw this one. After that, if you observe this one, this inner circle is hidden. So I will just draw the lines for that inner circle. Let us assume that it is a hidden right now. We will think about that when we take a section. Also, you can draw the section, this particular center line over there by taking this one. So I'll just draw the center line over there. Okay. Then this should have a center line format. Okay, now I have to draw this curve. So it is starting from this corner and ending with this corner. Okay, so how we can draw it? Having radius equal to how many? 50 mm. Okay, so there is one option that you can just join this part first, this to this. this to this, okay, and then this, and then if you want to just fillet it by radius of R50, so go for the fillet option is there, fillet, then select that radius option here radius is equal to 50, put it here 50, and select this part as well as this part. If it is not getting here, so we can go, there is one more option, so I'll show you. Fillet radius is equal to 50, this to this, invalid radius, it's too large, so no issue. So we can have another option, so that I will try. So I'll just draw here two circles of radius equal to 50. So I'll start with here, start from here, draw one circle of 50 mm radius, then another circle from here 50 mm, and wherever it cross from that point you have to draw one more circle with the radius equal to 50, okay, and after that this initial two circles you can delete, and then remaining you can trim it. So how we can trim? You can go to the trim option, okay, so likewise you can trim, and just whatever the other parts you can delete it, okay. So this is one more method, and just make it black color. So that's it, it is covered now. So almost we have completed this front view, only some hidden features are remaining that we will draw later on. So after that I will quickly go for the side view. For the side view, what we can do, we have to take the projection from the front end top, so you can go to this line. Then first of all I will take the projection of this center line, okay, then after that you just take this projections, then this part you will find first, after that you can take this projection for this this particular cylinder, then is there anything else, yeah, this one we have to take the projection from the side top view for this circles or that cylinder, so it is up to here, na? So that's why you have to draw up to here, so this to this, so having height is equal to 30, okay, then inner circle you can take the projection from inner for the inner circle, so that would be hidden. So for the side view we can directly draw the hidden lines because it is not going to change as it is a side view, because we have only sectional front view, so we can directly draw the hidden lines in the side view. So I will just take this part. So I have taken simultaneously all the projections, but you can start with a simple start with a one by one projection, and then you can immediately draw this part. You can see here this rectangle is there for this rectangle, this part, then you can see here one cylinder which is above that plate, and then you can see inside that cylinder there is a hole, inner hole, having radius equal to diameter is equal to 25, and if you observe this one, this should be hidden, so quickly you can make it hidden, okay. So this is also hidden, but we are going to change it, this part, as this is a sectional front view, that's why I have not done anything here. Other in side view we are not going to change anything, so that's why you can start with this, okay. Now next part, this curves we are going to draw. So here it is a radius equal to 20, so if you observe this, it is starting from this, and one full rectangle is there, or square like structure would be there. So I will start with this and I will just connect it, okay. Then I can directly make it fillet of radius equal to 20, so go to the fillet option, radius equal to 20, enter, this to this, and also this to this, so radius equal to 20, automatically it will take it. Now one more circle is there, that two holes of dia 10 mm, and that particular radius is same, or center line is same for this, so 20 by 20, so you can just draw a center here, or directly you will get the center from here if you make it fillet, that center is there, so you can just take this radius, diameter is 10, so radius equal to 5 mm, so similar to that here also you will get 5 mm, getting. After that you have to show only center line over there, so you can show that center line starting from here, otherwise afterwards you can show it, no issue, because there is a very less time, so I will complete other part here. Now next part, there is a here center line we have to draw first, so I will just draw the center line, this one. So this should have center line type. After that, there is a rib which is visible here in the side view, and starting from here ending with top, so you can take the projection of the rib from top view. So starting with this, so similar to that, this one also, and then finally what you can do, you can make it black. Okay, so that's it, this one is covered now. Almost all the side view we have completed. Only thing is that for this part we have to take the projections for this particular circle as a hidden lines, so we have to take the projection in the top view as well as we have to take the projection in the side view also. But in the side view, front view, so here in the front view it is not going to cut in when we take the section, so we will take later on. Before that, let me take the projection in the top view first. So you can take the projection in the top view for this particular circle. So in this region that circle is present, so that we have to make it mark it hidden line. I think many lines are there, so you have to be very careful while taking the projection, this one as well as this one. So you can go to this part, black color, just draw this one. So this is a symmetric object, so what we can do, we can make it mirror here also. So this is dashed. So you can take this part, one more part on this side. So you can go to the mirror option, this to this, mirror, select the mirror line. Okay, and just so in the last session we have seen some this particular, how to draw this particular hidden lines in the top view for this hole. Now this particular session we will saw think about the section lines in the front view. Okay, so what we can do, we will start with this one. So let us imagine that, hello, all the participants are there. Okay, now if you observe this diagram clearly, so the cutting plane is A along AA, cutting plane is along AA, so that's why that it is required to cut along this part. Okay, so when we take a cut, what happened, that holes are open, this rib is going to be open, so we have to make the hatching over there. So if you observe this one, this part is going to be open here. Okay, then this is also going to be open, so that hidden lines of this hole are visible. Why? Because that hole is going to be open, so that's why it is clearly visible here. Now we have to trim some part, middle part, during this within this diagram. So this we have to trim. So what we can do, we can delete this part. Okay, after that we have to check out whether it is connected properly or not. If it is not connected properly, it would not be possible to connect take this particular sections. Okay, now we have to go for the trim this part also, this part and this part. Okay, then also this part here, so you can just take this particular hatch, and then you can take this hatching here with this particular 15. Okay, and then this one, this one, this one, we have to make the hatching over there. So imagine that there is a, the object is being painted everywhere, and when you take a cut, then unpainted area we have to hatch, and also we do not supposed to hatch this rib area, rib portion, we do not supposed to hatch that. We have a one rule that we cannot hatching in the rib area, getting? So that's why we have to avoid that rib area. So do remember that we have to avoid the rib area Okay, now almost we have completed this sectional part here. Now one more thing is that we have to show this as a cutting plane. So using magenta color, you can show this cutting plane and change it to phantom one. Okay, so you just change it to phantom one. Also show the this particular center lines for this hole. So I can create a center line here. So you have to create this particular center line. Likewise, you can create, and then what you can do, you can just change it to center line mode. So center line mode is there. You just try for that center line, how to get that center line by changing the mode and other things. You can try, and what you can do, you can just mirror it on other side also. So you can go to the mirror option. This to this, this and then mode. Okay, this is how it is required to do. Then in the section, we do not supposed to show the hidden lines for this particular hole, because if you see this hole from the front, if you see this hole, if you see this hole from the front, that would be hidden, getting. But in the section, there is a one section. So when I take a cut here, that this part, this hole is going to be removed, but there is one more hole is there that would be present. So for that only, what you can do, you can take the projection from this particular center and show only center line. Do not show the hidden lines for the hole, because it is not going to cut. It is parted. This side is one, another side is one. So that cutting plane is not passing from that hole. So that's why we can show only cutting the center line over there. So that indicate that the hole is there. Okay, so this kind of center line you can show over there. That's it. Now only thing is that main is dimensions. So you can give the maximum dimensions. So maximum width here, height here you can give. Before that, you just make sure that this should be black color.
Ye bhi ho jane dunga
to be just off.